So we're just continuing on with some more housing dados, stop dados for our bottom. Fit the bottom in. I got that shelf set up in clamps just to keep everything in spot while I'm working away at it. And we're just chipping away, just like Paul Sellers, except without the experience or the talent. Literally just chipping away at it, nice and slow, keeping our hands out of the way of where we're pushing the chisel. A little bit deeper now so we can hit a bit harder. We're not worried about bruising our knife line so much now that we're getting deeper. Using the other edge as a guide right here, this edge right here, just sliding it over there. And take out a chip. And we'll just keep going until we get down to our gauge line right here. So now I'm pretty close to my gauge line. I'll make sure my chisel points up and start paring out the middle of it. Before I get right to the bottom, my chisel through my block of wood at about a 45 degree angle. I know I'm still high here. I'm just going to use that as a plane and clean the rest of it out to the right depth. Thank you. and the camera's in my way, but you get the idea. Just a rotor plane, which I need a real one, but this will do for now. And it's taken 4 or 5 attempts to get this rotor plane just right, but it's coming along. Seems to work better made out of softwood. I'm pretty sure this one's still a little narrow, but we'll give her a test fit. Yeah, we've got to widen it up just a bit. Just a touch. So I'm having a real time getting this Philister in here, and that's to match up with the back for the back panel to go in. You can kind of see it there, but it's getting really rough. But I'm thinking this space here is going to have a drawer in it, so I'm just going to leave that shallow. Now, when I do the top, I'm not sure how I'm going to do it, but I'm thinking of having the top overhang a little bit there, but if I overhang it a bit more, I don't think it would hurt. Maybe a little bit too big. But I can cut just this section right out, and then I can attach my backing onto here, which I don't know if I what I'm going to use for I don't know what I'm going to use for backing. Kind of getting low on the scraps here, but I'm thinking I might mill up some I've got some pallet wood around here somewhere. I think that might make an okay backing if it's milled up. We'll see what happens. The experiment continues. I've got some 3/8 plywood here. That would work really well. That's the same as the siding on the shop. Now that I'm looking at that, more ideas. We've been working away today. So, that's with the siding plane down for the back. So, I think that's going to work. Standing up here. So for a secondary wood, I think it might be all right. So I've got the top fitted on. And there's no glue on this. So it's fitting all pretty well. Slot for the back. Not too bad. Well, I keep looking at this piece of spruce with the cherry, and I don't like it. I don't like it at all. It looks cheap. So we'll save that panel for, I put a couple of coats of blow-on wax on it. By itself, it's nice, but it's just not doing it with the cherry. So we've got to think of something else. going to look much better. Much, much better. Maple and cherry, can't go wrong.